a casting director from CBS happened to catch me in an off-Broadway show. And so when they were casting Dukes, they were having a hard time finding Luke. So she told them that they should take a peek at me. So that's how I got the script, and they flew me out there to read with John.
Yeah, and Tom, the Dukes of Hazzard was a light-hearted comedy action series with a sort of a redneck background. Why do you think the show appealed to a global audience, not just only in the USA, and that it appeals to young and old worldwide?
I think the appeal of the show is basically pretty universal in that, you know, you're talking about family values, the family sticks together, and even the extended family, when it just, for example, if Boss and Roscoe got into trouble, we would help them as well, even though they were always conniving to get us in jail.
Yeah.
So, you know, it was a lot of fun. The show's a lot of fun to watch, and the action, obviously the vehicular action, was pretty amazing and kind of unprecedented. So there were a lot of factors that I think people, they just found it was something that different generations could watch together, too.
Yeah, and Tom, the brotherhood or sense of camaraderie that you had with John Schneider on set, who played Boak Duke, felt so real-like. And did you instantly hit it off straight away from the first day of casting? And what are your most funny stories on set or bloopers or working with John or scenes, stories behind the scenes of the camera?
Well, you know, there's not a lot of specific stories that I would bring up. I mean, some of the funny stuff is kind of personal, so
okay.
Can't really go there. But we would cover for each other, you know, if one of us wasn't feeling good, the other one would help out. And, you know, we spent a lot of hours in that car. I think some of our best memories are when we would be sitting in there doing things they called rear screen projection, where they show the scenery going by past you, and it looks like you're driving the car, but you're not really. We'd be in the car all day like that, and we'd sing and we'd tell stories to each other and smart talk and mess with the crew, and we had a really, really good time. I think that's what comes across on the screen, is that we really enjoyed each other's company, and actually the whole cast was like that. We truly enjoyed each other's company.
Yeah, and brings you on to the next person to speak about, Catherine Back, who played the iconic Daisy Duke, and not only brought another dimension to the show, but also became the poster girl of the show, and maybe a poster girl for her time across in America. And what was Catherine like? Did she resemble her character Daisy Duke in any way?
Well, she came from a small town in South Dakota, so, I mean, Catherine, you know, is still, I mean, John and Catherine are still two of my best friends. And she's a hot mummer. She's got a lot of sex appeal, and she also had a really nice sense of humor. And, you know, I figure she helped a few million guards through puberty. So she was, we had a nice recipe for that show.
And Tom, if I can bring you on to some of the legendary actors of the show that are sadly not with us anymore, Denver Pyle, Sawyer Brook, and James Best, and what are some of your fondest memories of working with these legendary characters? Sonny Shire, who played Enos, told us about a funny story about James Best, and do you have any sort of stories or memories that you would like to share about Sawyer Brook or Denver Pyle or James Best, or what, or sum them up as actors as well?
Obviously, Sonny would have better stories to tell about Jim. Jim was quite a character and a really good teacher as well. He taught acting, and one small story is that one of the students in his class was Quentin Tarantino.
All right.
So Quentin would come up and take class with Jim on a Thursday night, and Jim would let him sleep in the classroom, and then Quentin would come to the set the next day. And of course, you know, at that time he was a teenager, and he was working in a, you know, a video store down in Manhattan Beach, or down there somewhere along the coast. And, but, you know, 30 years later, he cast me in Django Unchained, and so I got to work for him in a really fine movie. I think that Sorrell and Jim did some of the best comic stuff, just like, you know, ensemble pieces. They were like Laurel and Hardy. They were amazing. Yeah. They were really terrific together. And, of course, Denver was a patriarch, and he kind of took all of us under his wing a little bit and tried to help us through the growing pains of dealing with celebrity and all that kind of stuff that comes along with a hit series.
Yeah, and Tom, what are your own thoughts or take on the Luke Duke character? And does he portray any some traits that you see in yourself in any way? Or do you think that if you summed up Luke, do you think he's very different to what you are in relation to roles you have played? Had you ever played a role similar to that sort of character before?
Oh, you know, I like to see myself as a hero. I think everybody likes to. I've had a couple of opportunities to do some pretty interesting driving, and I've helped some people out of situations where, you know, it took a little bit of ingenuity. But, you know, first of all, Luke was thoughtful and faithful to family and friends, and... you know, fun-loving, but at the same time, you know, not disrespectful. And I like to think that I am all of those things.
And Tom, what's your own favorite scene or episode of Dukes of Hazzard, and why? Why would you remember that episode even still to this day, or this scene, or what sticks?
I think probably Ghost of General Lee was one of my favorites. The episode where they thought we were dead, so we got to go see our own funeral. That was pretty cool. Also, Boys Nest Bears is one that the second one I directed.
Okay.
I directed like five. And, you know, a lot of them, you know, people will bring it up when I'm signing autographs. They'll bring up a certain episode, and I go, wow, it's hard for me to put together where that came from. There was a lot of work, and we did it at a really rapid rate, but it was a great deal of fun. It was probably the most fun I've ever had in my career.
And Tom, how would you like to be remembered for your role as Luke Duke in the Dukes of Hazzard? How would you like to be...
strong.
Yeah.
You know, faithful to my friends and family.
Okay. And Tom, before we let you go now, we're running this sort of a quiz, a celebrity quiz, and it's caused an awful lot of interest and stuff like that. Our current leader is actually Joseph Marcel, who played Jeffrey in The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, and in second place is Murdoch, who played by Dwight Schultz in the A-Team. And it's just a very simple celebrity quiz, just 10 rapid quick-fire questions. It's called Celebrity, How Well Do You Know Ireland? So do you want to have a go? It'll only take a few...
Wait a minute. I mean, I can barely understand you, so rapid fire questions, it might be a problem.
Okay, I'll take them as very slow as I can, so Tom, okay? It's just simple, just 10 quick questions. Okay, so Tom...
I don't know much about Ireland.
Okay, can you name one colour in the Irish flag?
Green.
Correct, one from one. Can you name any county in Ireland?
Cork.
Correct, 2 from 2. What is March 17th known as worldwide?
I don't know.
Okay, that's...
Irish Independence Day?
Oh, close. It's a saint of us that drove out the snakes out of Ireland, but that's okay. Number 4, which of these is...
drove the snakes out.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Which of these is an Ireland tourist attraction? Cliffs of Moher, Brandenburg Gate, or Eistermouth Castle?
I don't know. The castle.
Okay, no problem. Number 5, what is the biggest river in Ireland? River Shannon, River Rhine, or River Lick?
River